In this video, we talk about whether you should take private lessons or group classes as a West Coast swing dancer. What's up, gang? Brian B. in a new Q&A section we're doing. We get a lot of emails and a lot of questions, and a lot of people have questions of whether or not they should take group classes or private lessons. So we're going to try to talk a little bit about that. Now, I think there's three considerations first that will shape whether or not you should take group lessons or private lessons. Number one is going to be a financial consideration, because group classes are obviously much cheaper and private lessons are more expensive. Number two is going to be your personality. Now, I've had a studio here in Louisville, Kentucky for about 15 years, and we found that some people, when they come in, are just much more comfortable taking private instruction that works for their personality, and then some people that does not work for their personality, and they enjoy the group classes. So there's a personality consideration as well. And number three would be your goals. What are your goals in your dancing? So let's kind of talk through. Let's go private lessons first. So the advantage to private lessons, I think your private lesson teacher can be your greatest resource in your journey. And my recommendation for people taking private lessons is perhaps to interview or to do some homework on several different coaches. Do not get hung up on your coach being a particular champion dancer. The only requirement I would have is, have they either achieved what you're trying to achieve, or have they helped other people achieve what you're trying to achieve? So if you're trying to become a proficient social dancer and you come across a teacher in your town that runs a nice social dance community, that could be a great resource. And actually, someone who's a champion level dancer who only coaches higher level dancers might not be perfectly aligned to your goals. On the flip side, if you're a competitor and you're trying to win perhaps a Jack and Jill, you would need a teacher that has some experience in doing well at those types of competitions, and then preferably a teacher who has taught other people to achieve those goals. So those are considerations in finding a private lesson teacher. Now, after you find one that works well for your personality, I would recommend sticking with them. In the early stages of our dancing, and I would say probably between 2 and 3 years, there is a mindset of students to jump around for specific teachers, and I think that that's a big miss on your part. So I recommend finding the right teacher and sticking with them, because as teachers, we have a path and a journey, and it takes some time. And the analogy I use is Tiger Woods, who's one of the best golfers on the planet ever. He has not had random coaches. He has changed coaches over his career, but he stays for each one for a long period of time to understand the philosophies to work towards the goals. So that's private lessons. On the flip side, group classes. What are the benefits of group classes? Well, in group classes, you, number one, obviously financial. You could probably afford more group classes for your dollar. And number two, West Coast is a social dance, right? So the ability to dance with different level dancers, different styles of dancers, different age ranges of dancers is one of the vital things. And I think that a group class can really give you that type of information. It also gives you a chance to sit back and observe across an hour different parts of a dance. So maybe you understand your footwork really well and the teacher's covering the footwork. Well, now you can sit back and maybe look at body positioning and listen to some things about leads. So I think group classes are ultimately valuable to your progress. Now, the traditional thing in social dancing is that there's three main elements. One of them is private instruction. The second one is group classes, and the third is physically actually social dancing. So I think mixing in all three of those is the ultimate triangle to get you to your goals. But of course, you have to look at your finances and plan those out. You have to understand your own personality in choosing a coach and in choosing whether or not private lessons or group classes match. And then you have to sit back and look at your goals and decide what you want to accomplish out of this journey. Most of the people watching this video, I think, are likely just trying to be solid social dancers. And that's where hopefully we come in to provide a lot of resources in online learning. We try to answer a lot of questions like this. So West Coast Swing Online, if you're not signed up there and are not on our email list, we share awesome stuff. Head to the blog, head to the website. We share tons of resources. We learn from tens of thousands of dancers around the country and around the world to share helpful resources. So I think this is, especially in the new age of video, a really helpful tool. It does not replace private lessons, group classes, or social dancing by any stretch, but it really does help fill in the gaps. And it's quite affordable. We give away a lot of free information. A little bit of it's paid, But I think that would help fill in the gaps between your private lessons, your group classes, and your social dancing. If you guys have any questions, hit us up, go to westcoastswingonline.com, shoot me an email, brian@westcoastswingonline.com. We will answer you back and point you in the right direction. Good luck on your dance journey, and we'll see you on a dance floor soon.